Batteries and supercapacitors, two powerhouses, but together they can either work like a dream team or cause electrical chaos. Let me show you how to harness their strengths without calling an ambulance. Take an example. Have you ever had trouble to start your car in the cold? Stick around because I will explain how supercapacitors can help avoid buying a new car battery in this winter. Hi, Norbert here. I'm an energy engineer. In video number 81, I explain how to make your batteries more practical. From your phone to your car battery with a cold start. You don't need to buy a new car battery every winter. Yes, starting is the most difficult task for your car battery. And it is the reason that people replace even a quite good battery too early. Now, with a supercapacitor, you may save money and keep your car running. I'll show later in the video calculations to prove that this works with the products that I bought. I'm still working on my micro CHP unit, a series that I put in pause, because sometimes you need experts and special equipment to get things just right. The experts are now on holiday.
How's it going, man?
That's why today we are diving into another energy issue, important in cold times, supercapacitors. You saw the thumbnail. Imagine two obstinate persons with strong opinions. If they clash, there's shouting, stress, and maybe even an ambulance call. Supercapacitors and batteries can behave the same way. C is voltage, S the opinion. With these components, it's very difficult to quickly change the voltage, like opinion with headstrong people.
By the way,
a battery is much more delicate than a supercapacitor. So if you compare it with people, then a strong argument can be traumatic for one of the two persons. In the case of a supercapacitor combined with a battery, the battery is the suffering part in this combination. Don't connect them together if the voltages are not nearly equal. You can use a laboratory power supply or LPS to charge each of them to the right voltage before they get to know each other. Before connecting strong voltage sources to each other, we need to equalize their voltages to avoid trauma to the most delicate and also to avoid personal harm and fire. Advantages of supercapacitors. Simple physical principle. Unlike batteries, which rely on complex chemical reactions, supercapacitors store energy electrostatically. This means extremely high current. If you are afraid of a short circuit on a car battery, then just imagine what will happen if you make a short circuit on a supercapacitor like I have, 500 farads. And let's not talk about a big one, 3000 farads, and they are also easy to get. There's no chemical wear, there's minimal maintenance, and you have a very long lifespan, rated for over 1 million cycles. While lead batteries may handle 500 to 1000 cycles, lithium batteries can live for thousands of cycles. On the other hand, the battery contains much more energy per kilogram and per liter, so volume, as you will see later in the calculations. If you put the two in parallel in a correct way, then the supercapacitors will absorb the very high start current of a cold car and protect the battery. The role of the battery is then to produce the consumed electrical charge so that the twin nearly immediately recovers the nominal voltage of the battery. In this way, that string is always prepared for the worst surprises. Let's now take a water analogy. A battery is like a water tank with a pump, where the pump represents the limited flow delivery. If you take much water in little time,
the pump is not able to maintain the flow and the pressure will go down.
And you can compare water pressure with the voltage, the electrical voltage. The supercapacitor is like a tank with wide connections to the main tank for instant flow, perfect for short bursts of water consumption. The supercapacitor quickly delivers power and the battery refills it less quickly afterwards, reducing stress and extending the battery life. What is a capacitor? It's a device that stores electricity in a more direct form than a battery. In its original form of electrical charge, with the electric field as a driving force. The capacity of this device is measured in farad. With 1 farad, the voltage over the device will change with 1 volt if you give it a current of 1 ampere during 1 second. As a formula, you have this, where delta V is a change in voltage, delta T a change in time in seconds, I is the current in ampere, and C is the capacity in farad. So if my supercapacitor is 500 farad, and it is, and delta T is a duration of 500 seconds, the current is 1 ampere, then the change in voltage will be 1 times 500 seconds divided by 500 farad, and that will be 1 volt. Then the capacitor contains 500 coulomb of charge and is only 40% full, because the voltage can rise to 2.7 volts, not only 1. This charge means that it can give a current of 1 ampere for 500 seconds or a current of 500 ampere for 1 second. And that's enough for starting a car if the engine is already warm. And after releasing this big current for 1 second, the voltage is again down only 1 volt. For example, from 30 volts to 12 volts. If you put 5 of them in series, because one capacitor cannot have more than 2.7 volts before breaking down. This easy discharge means that the battery has been protected against a big stress if it was connected with its two poles to the two poles of the capacitor. And this is an example of a slow charge and quick discharge. Another way of using the combination of the supercapacitor and the battery is a quick charge and slow discharge. That can be useful if you want to charge your telephone very quickly. The telephone battery cannot be charged so quickly, but the portable capacitor will receive this charge very quickly and then give it slowly to the battery in its own time. It's portable and can stay together with the telephone. Let's take an example. A smartphone wants to be charged with 2 ampere. If you charge the supercapacitor with a current of 10 ampere, it can release this current 5 times more slowly through a PWM system that you can make yourself without energy loss. And okay, I didn't make this myself. This component you can buy and you can put it together with a supercapacitor. Then you can take this compact system away together with your smartphone and leave the 10 ampere charger at home. The PWM system ensures that the voltage difference between the 13.5 volts of the capacitor bank, and that will go slowly down in voltage, and the constant 5 volts of the USB port, and that this voltage difference is not wasted. The fact that the voltage changes so little for a supercapacitor, even with big currents, makes it a very good voltage stabilizer. We compare now the energy capacity per unit of weight and volume. I just invite you to compare it with a simple AA rechargeable battery. In the case of a supercapacitor, we have the energy given by 1/2 CV². In this case, with these 5 capacitors, of total 13.5 volts, we have half times 500 farad times 13 square, and that is 42 kilojoule. For the 11 batteries, 13.2 volt, we have the storage capacity in ampere seconds times voltage, and that is 2 ampere hours per 3600 seconds in an hour, times the voltage of the real battery, and 11 of them. And then we have 95 kilojoule. And that's more than double the energy of the supercapacitors, which take also more space than these 11 small AA batteries. And you can see the 11 cells
are smaller than this pack of 5 capacitors.
I wanted to give a list of 12 super applications for supercapacitors, but realized that the video is becoming too long. Please tell me in the comments if the next week you prefer these 12 applications or that I continue with the micro CHP. Before we jump into the experiments, I'd love to invite you to join our Energy Home Do It Yourself community. Energy is vital for normal life, and you have to guarantee its availability at your home without costing too much. Moreover, energy is very related to the environment, so we can give a concrete contribution to the next generation of humankind. Maybe more important is that the other living beings that we share the planet with can continue to live in peace. Yes, let's be a bit modest and not assume that we are the most important. We share a planet with so many other life forms. I'm here to help you to master energy in all its aspects, being sustainable, paying less, and be secure of its supply. If you like this video, hit subscribe and share it with people who want to save energy, money, and also the planet. You can join the Facebook groups in English and in Italian. The links are in the description. That will enable a real two-way communication, and you will be among likewise people. Finally, you can support me by following the links to the products I use in this video, if you want to use supercapacitors yourself. I started this week as a partner for Amazon. More about that later. Experiments. 1. Individual charge and test. Some of the 5 seemed to charge quicker
when charging them all together with the same current in series.
I charged them individually during the first time. They seemed to need a slow formation charge of 0.1% of the farad number. That is 0.5 half an ampere for me. I went to nearly the maximum voltage of 2.7 volt.
Simple white LEDs can be useful for series charging with unequal capacitors. When charging in a series connection, all capacitors get the same current, and some capacitors might get a higher voltage than allowed. These LEDs start working at 2.5 volt. That's just a bit under the maximum allowed voltage for the capacitor. What a coincidence. But you must be present to see them. Remember, it's harmful or even dangerous to overcharge a capacitor.
2. Destructive experiment with a fuse or aluminium foil. If you like to do this project yourself, you can look in the description and see what I bought on Amazon. I will get a small commission if you buy components through my links. However, you will not pay this commission. Your price will be exactly the same as when you buy those components on your own account. The advantage of using my link is that you can profit from my experience with these components, and I will be very sincere about what I think about these components. For example, I bought the capacitors at a low price and an average opinion of 4 out of 5 stars. It had 3 moderate or negative comments on a total of 10. But the price difference with the others was significant, and I decided to test and charge them individually. Buying extra capacitors, if maybe 1 or 2 of these capacitors would be bad. It's my first experience with supercapacitors, and when I go on, I will buy higher quality, leveraging the experience which I do this week. I started this week on Amazon in 2 countries, in Italy, where I live, and also in the USA, where I have a lot of viewers. I will develop a larger market in Europe after a few months, and in the meantime, I will try to find a way to help you find those components in your country. Last year, I tried also to be an Amazon partner, but my channel was 4 times smaller than now. And here, a lab power supply recommendation. A flexible laboratory power supply is perfect for charging and also experiments. It's twice the price of a cheap car battery charger, but far more versatile. It's also easy to charge each type of battery and supercapacitor with the exact voltage and current which are in the specifications. So you will not overcharge it. That can be dangerous and at least cause damage. Check the affiliate link in the description to have yours today. The key points of this video are: supercapacitors deliver fast energy and reduce battery stress. They are ideal for cold starts, quick charging, and energy efficient do-it-yourself setups. Combine them with batteries for long-lasting and better performing systems. Don't forget to subscribe and share. Let's take charge of energy security together. We'll see us in the next video, the next week, and tell me if you want more of this. I will decide in this week what the next video will be about. It will be the micro CHP video series that is not yet complete, or supercapacitors. That will depend on you and the appointment with the technician of air conditioners. I wish you good energy.